Consider this diode circuit. Do you think all the diodes are on? For example, how we can be sure the D2 is on so that we can determine the current flowing through the resistor R2? For D1 and D3, we can assume they are on because of the VS positive and negative polarity and the way the diode D1 and D3 are connected to the source. To start, let's assume all the diodes are on and we find the currents I1, I2 and I in each branches, then we evaluate our results. So let's write a Kirchhoff current law KCL, and per our assumption we should have which it means since we assume that all the diodes are on and D2 and R2 are in parallel, then we can write now we need to prove that D2 is on because we assumed 0.7 volt would be across D2 and R2. Let's calculate I1. As you can see here, R1, D1 and D3, R3 are in series, so they should have a similar current flowing through them, which is I1. So we can write so I1 can be calculated by we calculated I1, we also found I, now we can find I2. Well, as you can see here, the current I2 becomes negative value, which it means our assumption about D2 being on was not correct. So we won't have a 0.7 volt across R2. Now we know that the D2 must be off, so we remove it from our analysis and we'll try to find the current flowing through the R2. By the way, if you like what you are watching, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. This will really help the channel to grow and encourage me to continue creating more and better content. Now back to the video. As you can see here, this is a simplified circuit after removing D2 because it was off. In this case, we will have only one current because all the elements are in series and the current I is the same as current I1. So to find this current, we can deduct all the voltage across the diodes D1 and D3 from the source voltage VS and divide them by all the resistors. So I1 equals I, and to find I or I1, we can write -12.7 minus 0.7 volts, 5.6 kilo ohm, 0.33 kilo ohm plus 2.2. All are in kilo ohms. So I1 equals I is 1.3 milliamp. So we found the current flowing through the resistor R2. Let's calculate the voltage across R2 because it will help us to understand why D2 was off. As you can see here, there is only 0.43 volts across R2, while all the diodes needed at least 0.7 volt to turn on. So we found the current flowing through the R2. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I will be making more videos on diodes, so please subscribe and hit the notification bell if you would like to get notified when I publish those videos.